औज़ु बिल्लाहि मिनश शैतान निर्जीम, बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमानिर रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द आउटब्रीडिंग डिवाइसेस, द फैक्टर्स और कंट्रीवेंसेस विच प्रमोट क्रॉस पोलिनेशन। टुडे वी विल टेक अप एजेंसीज और टाइप्स या एजेंट्स ऑफ क्रॉस पोलिनेशन। द एजेंट्स और एजेंसीज are what we can say vectors responsible for the transfer of pollen grains from one flower or from the anther of one flower to the stigma of another flower. They have been broadly divided into two categories. Abiotic agents or agencies and biotic agents or agencies. Abiotic agents means non-living agencies or agents. Biotic means living. The two non-living agencies are agents which take part in this transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma of a flower. They are wind or air and water. And the various biotic agents, living organisms which take part in pollination or which act as pollinating agents, they include insects, birds, bats, snails, ants, etc. And these are the various biotic agents or living organisms which act as pollinators, which act as pollinating agents. First, we will take up the abiotic agents. And from the abiotic agents, we will take first wind pollination. The type of pollination in which pollen grains are transferred from pollen from anther of a flower to the stigma of another flower born on another plant by the agency of wind or air is called anemophily, and this type of pollination is anemophilous pollination. And if we can say the transfer of pollen grains by the agency of wind is called anemophily. The pollination in which the pollinating agent is wind, it is called anemophily, and such flowers are known as anemophilous flowers. The flowers which are wind pollinated are called anemophilous flowers and are characterized by the following features. The flowers which are wind pollinated, they are characterized by the following features. Number first, they are generally small, colorless, odorless and nectarless. Any these flowers which are wind pollinated, they are generally small, they are colorless, they are odorless and they are nectarless. Number second feature is calyx and corolla. Calyx and corolla, two accessory whorls, helping whorls, are reduced or absent. And either calyx and corolla, they are reduced, they are very small, or they are altogether absent. Now the third feature is the flowers are usually unisexual. Flowers are usually unisexual. Any wind pollinated flowers are generally unisexual and produce large number of pollen grains. Any wind pollinated flowers are characterized by unisexual flowers and they produce large number of pollen grains. Now, a fourth feature is the pollen grains are often dry. Pollen grains are often dry. They are pollinated by wind, so it is an essential feature of them that they are often dry. Dry, small and light in weight so that wind or air can easily transport them. They are often dry, small and light in weight. However, in some cases like pinaceae, which is the characteristic feature, pollen grains are winged. Any winged pollen grain is the characteristic feature of a gymnosperm family that is known as pinaceae. This question is often asked in the entrance examinations, that winged pollen grains are the characteristics of pinaceae. Winged pollen grains are the characteristics of pinaceae. Number fifth feature, the stigma stigmas are large, well exposed to the air, feathery or branched to catch the air-borne pollen grains. And on one hand, pollen grains are produced in large numbers. They are often dry, small and light in weight. And in some cases, they are winged. The stigma is large, well exposed to the air, feathery and branched, so that it can catch the air-borne pollen grains easily. It can catch the air-borne pollen grains easily. Number sixth feature is, in some cases, the anther bursts suddenly to throw the pollen grains into the air, what we call as gunpowder mechanism. is an important characteristic of some anemophilous flowers, and in which what they do, the anthers burst suddenly at mature to throw the pollen grains into the air. This mechanism is called gunpowder mechanism. The common examples of wind pollinated flowers are grasses, sugarcane, maize, coconut, etc. And these are the common examples of wind pollinated flower, that is grasses, sugarcane, maize, coconut, etc. And let us repeat this: anemophilous pollination or anemophily. The pollination in which the pollinating agent is wind, it is called anemophily, and such flowers are called as anemophilous flowers. The flowers which are pollinated are called anemophilous flowers and are characterized by the following features or adaptations. Now, first, they are small, colorless, inconspicuous, odorless, and nectarless. Number second, calyx and corolla are either reduced or absent. Number third, the flowers are generally unisexual and produce large number of pollen grains. Number fourth, the pollen grains are often dry, small and light in weight. However, in some cases, pollen grains are winged, as in Pinaceae. Number fifth feature, the stigma are large, well exposed in the air, hairy, feathery or branched to catch airborne pollen grains easily. In some cases, the anther bursts suddenly to throw the pollen grains into the air. That is called a gunpowder mechanism. The common examples of wind pollinated flowers are grasses, sugarcane, maize, coconut, etc. This is all for today. Thank you. Assalamu alaikum.